गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इक्विवेलेंट फ्रैक्शंस. इक्विवेलेंट फ्रैक्शंस शोज द सेम पार्ट ऑफ अ होल. नाउ व्हाट डज इट मीन? इट मीन्स दैट फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ वी डिवाइड अ सर्कल इनटू टू, दिस इज द सर्कल, आई हैव डिवाइडेड द सर्कल इनटू टू पार्ट्स. सो द डिनोमिनेटर इज the total number of equal parts, that's the denominator here which we write under this line, and the numerator is the selected part. So we have selected how many parts? One part. So it means that this is half of this whole circle. This particular part is equal to this part. How? We have divided the whole the circle into four equal parts. Okay, so what's the denominator here? 4. Why? Because the total number of parts is the denominator, which we write at the down, and the selected part we write on the top. So how many parts we have selected? That is 2. That means if we either you can take it this ways, or you can take the 2 on the top, or this half. That means if this is equal, like we have divided the circle into 2, that means we have divided into half. So this also is divided into half. How? Here we have just divided into 2 parts, one part and the second part, and here we have divided into 4 equal parts, and out of 4 equal parts we have separated 2 parts. So with what is left here? Half. Here half. Okay, so this is equivalent fractions. Now let us come down and see further that in equivalent fractions we get a series of equivalent fractions. How? By multiplying the numerator and the denominator by same number. Now what does it mean? It means that the number which we are going to multiply the numerator with the same number, you will multiply the denominator also. How? Let us take example. Here I have taken example of 3/4. Okay, first I have divided 3 in by 2. So the equivalent fraction says the number of times you will divide the numerator, the same number of times you will divide the denominator also. Okay, so here I have divided 3 with multiplied 3 with 2, same number of time I will multiply 4 also with 2. I cannot multiply numerator with 2 and denominator with 4 or 3 or 1. No, this is wrong. This is not equivalent fraction. Equivalent fraction says the number of times you are multiplying the numerator, the same number of times you will multiply the denominator also. So when you will multiply 3 into 2, you will get the answer 6, and when you will multiply 4 into 2, you will get the answer 8. Similarly, next we will see that 3 multiplied by 3, the number of times multiplying numerator, the same number of times you are multiplying the denominator. So 3 threes are 9 and 4 threes are 12. So now what can you see here? It's the same, just like the previous one, the number of times we are multiplying the numerator, the same number of times we are multiplying the denominator. Like this I have done till 4, 5 and 6, up till 6. It can go further also, but that is not in your course. So we will take only up till how many equivalent fractions we have taken? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I give you a question, write 5 equivalent fractions of any number, you will do like this. 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, 4 time and 5 time. We will not take 3 into 1 and 4 into 1. Why? Because the answer will be 3 by 4 only. So which is already being done. One time is already being done for you. So we will not take 3 into 1. We will start always with 2 while getting the equivalent fractions. So thus we can say that 6 by 8, this one, when you are doing multiplying by this. 9 by 12, this one. 12 by 16, 15 by 20 and 18 by 24 are few equivalent fractions of 3 by 4. Why we are saying few equivalent? Because there are more, but we are just taking the equivalent fractions up till 5. So these are the fractions which are few fractions which are equivalent to 3 by 4. Okay.